our sole contention is preserving the Chinese economy. China's economy is slowing down despite what the government says for two reasons. First, education and skill have diminished long 18. The slowdown of the Chinese economy is not a cyclical downturn. It is a deep transition which will shape the future of China and the rest of the world. China's slowdown has to do with the diminishing effectiveness of several contributors to the productivity growth in the previous three decades and a collapse of demand, Johnson 19. China's economic growth slowed last year as the trade war with the United States intensified. All is not well, and the deceleration of, is coming on the consumption front. There's a massive collapse for demand for Chinese manufactured goods. What happens with China's economy also has a huge impact on the rest of the world. A slowdown would hammer emerging markets, which depend on China. And a BRI success is specifically key to rejuvenating the economy. Shulman 19. China's economy is now struggling. Chinese leaders are therefore looking to boost overseas investment and trade under the BRI. Beijing is using BRI to export and find new markets. China's rejuvenation requires expanding its normative power abroad. China's push for greater influence is deemed necessary for continued survival. However, the BRI is on a crash course now. SARS-CoV-19, the One Belt, One Road project, could experience obstacles unless Beijing devotes the proper resources to protecting its investment. The approach could fail before it's completed. Fortunately, expanding the BRI to the European Union ensures its success for two reasons. First, it legitimizes the project Italy proves, Hogeni 19. The Italian government is expected to endorse the BRI, and Rome's move comes at a time where Europe tries to forge a coordinated China policy. Support for BRI would legitimize China's geopolitical ambitions. And second, it provides financial stability. Curtin 17. The Belt and Road Initiative truly is a globalizing project. China cannot financially and logistically manage such an ambitious project on its own. Prominent regional actors cannot be counted upon to build the Belt and Road, and the only possible and necessary partner is the European Union. Critically, the success of the Belt and Road Initiative is key to boosting China's economy, CSIS 19. The BRI has the potential to yield considerable economic gains for China. Developing infrastructure with neighboring countries will reduce transport costs and allow for a broader range of goods to be traded with fewer regulatory hurdles. China will also boost growth in its lower-income provinces by building overland economic connectivity with Central Asia. Investing in large-scale infrastructure projects enables China to export its excess savings and overproduced goods and put its SOEs to work. If successfully implemented, the BRI could reorient the world economy towards China. Investment into strategic locations will help diversify China's transport network for critical natural resources like oil and gas. And Eurasian BRI expansion independently boosts China's economy, Freeman 16. China is in the process of becoming the world's permanent economy. The purpose is to promote its economic integration with Asia and Europe. That is an area with a population of 4.4 billion and a current economic output of 21 trillion. The One Belt, One Road project seeks to build linkages and break down barriers between China and the various economic communities. These communities include the EU, and as the concept is implemented, the EU and China should draw ever closer commercially. The project can bring about a second major advance in China's wealth and power, and trans-region networks will not improve connectivity for landlocked countries, but also speed up data exchanges between Europe and Asia. China will become the center of economic gravity. Preserving China's economy is critical for two impacts. First, global recession. China's economic slowdown, if unchecked, will cause a global recession, Clement 16. The world could be about to enter a recession that will be more brutal than 2008, thanks to China's slowing economy, experts fear. China's slowdown is likely to mean company earnings are lower, keeping interest rates and commodity prices at rock bottom. China's slowdown are part of the reason that stock markets have shed billions in value, and China's economy could cause problems for the whole world. China's tumbling economy would have the biggest impact for economies, which depend on demand from China. The combination of factors that proved to be a toxic cocktail that sparks financial meltdown across the world and a recession that is more severe than in 2008 with widespread devastation. And the 2008 recession puts millions of people into poverty and unemployment, ILO 09. The global economic crisis led to a dramatic increase in global unemployment by more than 50 million. 200 million are pushed into extreme poverty, and poverty leads to death, millennial legacy 18. 18 million people every year die from poverty, thus we urge it to avert.